Sid, toast. Will, toast. Anton? Yeah! Don't worry, everybody gets toast. Do what? Yeah, we got a little butter. Okay, there we go. What is it? Oh, it's time now for stupid... I need the pencil? Thank you very much. Stupid human tricks. We have people who know how to do odd little peculiar things that they've taught themselves or had others teach them to it, or whatever. And now they'll come out and demonstrate these skills for us, and we'll all be entertained. This is only a competition. This is not an exhibition. Whatever that goes like. Anyway, stupid human tricks. Our first participant tonight is Jim Murphy. Jim, are you back there, sir? Jim.
Hi, Jim. Good to see you.
Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you. Where are you from, Jim?
Audience, New York.
And what do you do for a living?
I'm a personnel and training director for a convenience store chain.
Do you enjoy that line of work?
Love it.
Well, good for
Love
you. And your trick tonight is what?
Well, what I'm going to do is I'll be removing the bottom from this bottle using nothing but my bare hands.
Mm-hmm. Wait a minute. You remove the bottom from the bottle?
Just the bottom.
So you mean actually cut through the glass?
Right through the glass.
Now, how did you learn how to do this?
Helping my dad out in his tavern, a guy came in, said, have I got a trick for you? It cost me a dollar.
Uh-huh.
And he did it.
So this is one of those bar tricks. Somebody comes in and says, I bet you I can take the bottom off of...
That's what it is.
Okay.
That's
right.
What it is.
This is Jim Murphy, ladies and gentlemen, and his trick will be removing the bottom from a bottle of beer.
Right.
Do you need anything for this, Jim?
Nothing at all. Maybe a drum roll.
Okay, Anton. Jim Murphy, ladies and gentlemen, removing the bottom of the bottle. What happened?
Well, I don't know. I don't know. Every once in a while, that'll happen. You get a really
nothing
strong...
is what...
Right. You can see the beer foaming.
Right.
Would you like to try another? Maybe it was the drum roll.
All right, let me try it.
Okay.
This is really not how the segment goes.
No.
And what do I do? Just this?
Just that. Hard.
Well, I'm doing it.
The top. Otherwise...
Well, you do what? You hold it up here?
Yeah. Firmly with the heel of your hand. That's never happened before.
Would you like some toast?
No, thank you. I have some back.
Now, this is you. No, wait a minute. This is starting, like, it's starting to crack. Is that possible?
We don't want to, loosen it up for you.
Okay, I'm sorry. All right,
would you like to try again?
No, I don't want to try it again. Okay. You do it.
All righty, here we go.
I got my hands full.
Let me...
Now, this was cut, wasn't it?
No. Oh, no.
Well, do it again. Let me see you do it again. Do it again.
No!
how do you do that? Is it just the pressure?
You hold it firmly and,
yeah.
Right, let me try. And use the heel of your hand.
Heel of my hand. That's very unbelievable. Nice job, Jim. Pleasure to meet you. Thank you. Oh, thank you. Did a little trick. I did a little trick, Paul. I'm so pleased I was able to do a little trick like that. That's right. I'll have that now in my bag of tricks. Christina. Seriously, what time is rehearsal? Christina Capani. Is Christina Capani back there? And this is your her father, Paul, right?
Right?
Nice to meet you, Paul.
Nice to meet you.
Hi, Christina. How are you?
Hi.
Nice to see you.
Hi.
What? How old is Christina?
She just turned two, about
two years old.
Yeah, 2 years old.
And a beautiful little girl.
She saw the bubbles earlier.
Doesn't she?
Yeah. She saw the bubbles earlier.
Oh, bubbles earlier? Sure. You want me to turn it on? It's really not how the segment goes. Okay, turn it on. It's the bubble machine, and it'll take a couple of minutes to heat up, and then we'll have toast and bubbles, ladies and gentlemen. See? You like the bubbles? Oh, okay, that's enough. There you go.
Enjoy that.
David,
there you go. You want some toast?
Thank you.
All right, now. Now, Paul, your lovely daughter, first of all, where are you guys from?
Dublin, Ohio.
Oh, Dublin, Ohio. Great. That's where Bobby Rahal is from.
Jack Hanna.
Yeah, nice to have you here. What is the trick that you folks will do for us
today? Well, just watch her eyebrows. Okay. Say, Christina, do your trick. Do your trick.
Okay. Well, geez, that was certainly interesting. There it is, and there she is, her eyebrows. Thank you very much, Paul. Nice meeting you. Bye, Christina. Bye-bye. Oh, gosh almighty. Is there a Jody Shimura? Shamayura. Hi, Jody, how are you?
I'm great, how are you?
Nice to see you. Tell me about your last name. I'm sorry I didn't get it right there.
It's Shimamura.
Shimamura. Nice to see you, Jody. Where are you from?
I'm from Bethel, Maine.
Bethel, Maine.
Yeah.
It's a beautiful state, Maine, isn't it? Especially this time of year. It's great.
Great.
Yeah, what do you do for a living in Bethel?
I work in upstate New York. I'm director of sales and marketing for Granger Balloons USA.
Oh, so you're involved with the...
With the
balloon industry. Yes, sir.
Yeah.
And I couldn't help but notice that you have a balloon there with you.
I do have one, yeah.
Does this have anything to do with your trick?
Sure.
No, oddly enough, it doesn't. The man just travels with a balloon. Okay, Jody, tell me what you're going to do here.
I'm going to climb inside this balloon through a 4-inch hole, and then you're going to help me get out of it.
Maybe. Now, but seriously, explain that again. You're going to climb in through this tiny little opening here.
I'm going to climb inside
uh-huh.
without the air coming out, or minimal air coming out,
uh-huh.
and I'm going to stand up inside it, and then you're going to help me get out of it.
I find this harder to believe than the guy who busted the beer bottles.
You do.
I don't think this can be done, unless it's a little trick. Is it a trick?
No.
Is this one of those trick balloons?
No.
Like a trap door?
Could be.
All right. Jody Shimamura.
Right.
Okay. We'll climb into his balloon, and then I get you out with a pencil. That's what this is for.
Yep. I'm offering you protection if you'd like it.
For what purpose? Is it going to be loud when it goes?
Could be.
How loud is it going to be?
Maybe like a gunshot.
Oh, I can withstand
You can
that.
Handle
Living
it?
Living in New York, I certainly ought to be able to. You want a drum roll or anything here?
Nah, it takes a few seconds.
Okay. How big is this balloon?
It's supposed to be 8 feet, but it's a little smaller.
Yeah. Would this be a weather balloon or a...
It's an advertising balloon.
Advertising balloon. Mm-hmm. Yeah. A lot of people use balloons to advertise?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, all right.
Tons of people. I have a backup.
He's all... That's great. I'm sorry, Jody, we don't have any more time. It's a joke. Will you relax? Okay, let's give it a... What happened there? Probably a faulty balloon is what it looked like to me.
I poked it with my finger.
Oh, you hit... Okay, here we go. Jody, right, we'll try it again. But it looked good up to that point, didn't it? All right, here he goes.
I'm going to show the prisoner.
No. What, now you're taking your belt off?
Well, maybe I caught it on that.
Yeah, maybe you did. Maybe we'll have to finish this up tomorrow night. Okay, here goes Jody into the balloon. Oh, my goodness. And, oh, God. Yes, sir. Very nice. Here we go. Bingo. Jody, thank you very much. Nice to see you. Appreciate your help. Jody Shimamura. Are we out of time? Okay. We got to do station identification, then we'll be right back.